And I'm going to ask you to join in with me when we say that a people united will never be defeated. 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 Right on, right on. I'm going to tell you, it is so good to see all of us here. Organized labor, the AFL-CIO, you can't do any better than that. To see all of the neighborhood groups and organizations, people all united together, local elected officials. I didn't see Alderman Ed Smith, but if he don't get here, I'm speaking for him anyhow. If he ain't here, I'm speaking for him. Because I know that he, along with all of the aldermen, are committed to this process that we're going through. You know, when I came to this community 25, 30, 40 years ago, you can walk down the streets and see help wanted signs. And you could get a job. And you could walk to the next corner. And there were openings. There were help wanted signs. Now you walk and you see things boarded up. You see companies like Brock's pulling out and leaving the neighborhood. Well, if they're going to leave, we want them to leave some behind. We want them to leave something like $10 million. Leave some opportunities for us to grow and develop. $10 million can go a long way. So, Mr. Brock, if you are listening, please go in your kitty. Open up your piggy bank and leave $10 million for us to rebuild what you've helped to destroy. And that is the confidence and the opportunities for the people. Now I know that the Walmart people are wanting to come in. And let me tell you, this is America. Our people believe in organizing. We believe in unions. We believe in collective bargaining. We believe in the right to negotiate. We believe in the right to sit at the table. And anybody who thinks that they can deny the opportunity for people to organize themselves into unions so that they can join together and fight, they are mistaken. They are mistaken. Unions will live, will thrive, and will survive. We are standing here today, but not only are we going to stand today, we're going to stand tomorrow, and we're going to stand the next day, and we're going to stand the next day, and we're going to keep marching, we're going to keep demonstrating, we're going to keep negotiating until there is justice. Until there is opportunity, until corporate America knows that they cannot rape our communities and then leave us hanging high and dry, we will not stand by and let it happen. And so, yes, I join with all of you. I join with the food and commercial workers. I join with the AFL-CIO. I join with the South Austin Coalition. I join with Bethel New Life. I join with all of us who come together to say that hell no, we ain't gonna take no more. We will fight back and fight back. Some of our elected officials couldn't be here, but there's a friend of mine who wanted to stop and did stop, and he's on his way to another rally. And I think you ought to meet him and you ought to know him. But State Senator Barack Obama is standing and he came by. Barack, I think you ought to come on out and say hello to such a group as this one. State Senator Barack Obama.
Thank you. How's everybody doing today? You just heard from one of the best congressmen in the country. And the reason he's one of the best congressmen in the country is he shares our values. He believes in a decent wage for a day's work. He believes that we shouldn't be investing $87 billion in Iraq when we can't invest $87 billion right here on the west side of Chicago. And he believes, and all of us believe, that corporations have an obligation to their workers and to their communities. And I am looking forward to going to the United States Senate and helping fight that fight. And while I'm in Springfield, I'm going to be fighting that fight to make sure that each and every one of you get the kind of treatment that we deserve. This is the only way that we can build a middle class in America. To make sure that everybody gets a decent opportunity, everybody gets a decent wage, and everybody gets a piece of the American dream. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.